congregation of song. Praise God. How many of you glad to be into the house of God?
Amen.
Amen. I've been fighting the cold all week, praise God, but I'm here. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
God is truly worthy to be praised. Hallelujah.
Yes.
I'll sing a little song, praise God. Hallelujah.
Yeah,
oh, hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Grace be to you and peace from God our Father, from the Lord Jesus Christ. Blessed be God, even the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercy and the God of all comfort. Comfort us in all our tribulation that we may be able to comfort them which are in many troubles. God, the comfort wherewith we ourselves are comfort of God. For as the suffering of Christ abound in us, so our consolation also abounds by Christ. And whether we be afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation, which is effectual in the enduring of the same suffering which we also suffer. For whether we be comforted, it is for your consolation and salvation. And our hope of you is steadfast, knowing that as ye are partakers of suffering, so ye shall be also consolation. Amen.
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 All right, we're going to move forth in our service with our elder coming forth with prayer, open prayer.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Truly, you want the God for being here, being back in the house of the Lord. Amen. We worship him in spirit and in truth. Amen. Bless and magnify his name.
Yeah.
Amen. There's no other place to greater to be, amen, in the house of the Lord.
Yeah.
Amen. The God is worthy. He's worthy of our praise.
Yes.
Amen. Whatever we do, we wave our hands, or pat our feet.
Yes.
Or just sit out here and rock. Amen. God is deserving of it.
Yes.
Amen. So we just go, amen, just magnify God. Amen.
Amen.
And just lift up his name.
Yes, yes, Lord.
Because if it had not been for the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. I know there's a song, I know it's an old cliche, but it bears some truth in it.
Yes.
That if it had not been for the Lord,
yes,
amen, we wouldn't be here.
Amen.
Amen. We wouldn't have the opportunity just to raise our hands.
Amen.
Just to clap our hands, our pat our feet.
Yes.
Amen. Because he is a keeper.
Yes.
Amen. The Bible says he that keepeth Israel.
Yes.
He shall not slumber nor sleep. Amen. We can make it personal because he has kept me.
Yes.
From danger seen and danger unseen. He has kept you and I. He has kept us. He is a keeper. Amen. So truly just give out. We magnify the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're not going to be long. Amen. Just lift our hands. Amen. We'll just lift our hands. Glory be to God. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
And just bless the Lord. Amen. Just bless the Lord. I know we'll be waiting on an open prayer. But sometimes we just gotta magnify God ourselves. Amen. You got a mouth. The Bible says we enter into his gates with thanksgiving. And enter into his courts with praise. Amen. Open your mouth and just bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Hallelujah. And I will bless the Lord all my soul. And all that is within me. I will bless his holy name. Oh, hallelujah. He's a keeper. He's my rock. Salvation. Glory to your name, God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord God, for keeping me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God, for being a keeper, a mighty keeper. Oh, God, I thank you. Hallelujah. Oh, God, I magnify you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, God, I thank you for watching over. Last night we slept and slumbered, Lord God. I thank you for watching over all last week, God. Keep us, oh God, hallelujah. Watch over our parents and our children, Lord God. Our spouses and our neighbors and friends, hallelujah. Oh God, I thank you, you're a keeper, Lord God. You kept my mind, Lord, hallelujah. Of all the confusion going on. Hallelujah, God, I thank you for a peace of mind, Lord God. To be able to lay down at nighttime and have a peaceful night's sleep. God, I thank you for a peace of mind, Lord God. Thank you, Jesus, for a peaceful mind, oh God. Oh God, I know where my help comes from. Thank you, oh God, for your blood that cleans all guilt. ask and we thank you, God. Your son, Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. Give God a hand praise. Thank you. Amen. True, we're for a high time. We thank God for each one that's here.
Thank you, Lord.
When our bishop and wife is in absence, we just magnify the Lord.
Thank you.
Amen. And just like to give a brief testimony, then we're going to call our announcement. Amen. I know y'all, a lot of y'all been wondering how Sister Sullivan's been doing. She's doing fine.
Praise the Lord.
She's doing fine, amen.
She's
moving around.
Lord.
Amen. Her mind is. Well, y'all know. It's about that.
All right, now.
Amen. She's about talking like her old self.
Yeah, all right now. Come on.
Yeah, she's about talking like her old self. So I told her the other day when I was over there, I said, Ma, you almost back. Amen.
So all right.
Amen. She's moving around, you know. One day she was sitting up eating. Amen. And she's able to get around and walking. She got a walker. She's able to go to the kitchen and stuff. And sit down at the table and eat. Amen. We thank God for your prayers. Amen. Keep praying for my father.
Yes,
amen. They need your prayers.
Amen.
Amen. So we just thank you guys.
Amen.
Amen. This time we're our announcements. Amen. Give God that praise.
We just thank God for that praise report, because we should have been praying for Sister Sullivan.
Amen.
And
she's
going to continue to be in our prayers. Thank
Amen.
God for that. This is, please update your contact information with our office. And Elder Sharanda Williams, you give this to Elder Sharanda Williams. And your address, your phone number, your cell number, either your email or your birthday. So let's get this application to Sister Sharanda, Elder Sharanda. There will be a prayer walk on January 27th. And also, this is Amnesty program for the criminal court. And this is in the Little Rock District Court, 600 West Markham, from 8 o'clock in the morning to 8:30 a.m. Monday through Friday. And this is for the month of February. For further information, you can contact Natalie Short, 371-4725. And our regular announcements are Men's Ministry on the third Saturday at 7, Women Joy Fellowship on the fourth Friday at 7, first and third Sunday at 6:30 we have services, first Wednesday night and every second Sunday choir rehearsal, first Sunday and third, every third Sunday the praise team rehearsal, and our Bible studies at Wednesday night at 7, Sunday schools at 9:30, and our morning worship at 10:45. Thank you. These are our announcements.
Amen. One more announcement. We are having a youth program for Black History Month. So youth will begin rehearsing on Saturday mornings at 11 o'clock. So bring your youth out on Saturday mornings at 11 o'clock. We will have a program. And the program is going to be fourth Sunday in February.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Come on, praise the Lord. Come on, say praise the Lord. It's good to be back in the house of the Lord. Thanks to all who's been praying with me. Amen. That flu is ugly, and I don't like it. But we're going to go on in the name of the Lord. Amen. We're just going to go and bless the Lord this morning. Come on, give the Lord a hand of praise right now. We want everyone to be mindful about this flu season. If you know that you are, you know, healing from a cold, make sure you be hospitable. Watch the handshakes, shake the arm, or give them a dap with your fist. We want to educate y'all. We want to rebuke these germs in the place. Is that all right? It ain't that we're loving on each other, but we want to be smart. Amen. Come on, give the Lord another hand of praise. Hallelujah. It's so good to be back in the house of God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
To be able to praise his name.
Yeah. Thank you, Lord.
And lift him up.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Come on, just give the Lord another hand of praise.
Hallelujah.
Just begin to lift your hands all over the building. Let's speed it up a little bit.
You deserve it. You deserve it.
Make the Lord able.
Thank you, Lord.
prepare your hearts. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. He is a need-meeting God.
Yes, he is.
Every need, he can meet it. I'm not just talking, I'm talking about what I know.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What I know. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I'm one of those. I might not look like what I've been through. Hallelujah. But there's a testimony. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. If you trust him, he'll come through. If you trust him, hallelujah. He cannot fail. We serve a God that cannot fail. Glory to God. Hallelujah. If you have your offering ready, would you stand? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. If you're still preparing, that's fine. To God be the glory. Hallelujah. Stretch your offering toward him. Hallelujah. If you don't have one, stretch your hands toward him. Hallelujah. Father God, I thank you, Lord, for this day, Lord. Lord, I thank you for everything that you've placed in my hand, God. Oh, Lord, help us to be good stewards, oh, God, of everything that you've given us, God. Oh, Lord, we plant this seed into good ground, God. We expect a great harvest, God. Lord, we thank you for the increase, God, in our lives, God. Increase, God, in our families, God. Increase in our ministry. Oh, God, we thank you for this community. We thank you for this city, God. And Lord, we claim all that is good for kingdom purpose, God. Lord, we thank you. We bless you. Lord, thank you for this seed in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Starting from the rear, the ushers are coming. Hallelujah. Starting from the rear rows, would you please face the wall and come? Worship and dance.
Thank you. Lord. Loud when you get up.
For this amazing house. Thank God. We're going to pray for the shepherd of this house, Bishop and Lady Hill, in their travel. Thank God for my wife, Ellis, around the way. The elders, the ministers, the members. I thank God for our visitors who are not so visitors as family. I have two visitors in the building. We want to acknowledge Overseer Michael Jones, right where you are, and Michael Smith. Look like you're all the way from Las Vegas, Nevada. We thank you for joining in. And all of those that are viewing us live over the screen, we thank God and hope God touches you right where you are. How many of you love the Lord? Hallelujah, hallelujah. See, I don't know about you, but I love the Lord. Lord, I just can't contain myself. My God, I'm gonna give some scripture here. I got some word today that God has put on my heart. I won't be long, but I think it's relevant for the time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, I don't know if you feel it how I feel. Hallelujah. I want you to turn your book. It's a familiar scripture. You've heard it a million times. But God gave me something, a twist he wants me to share with you. Go to the book of Luke.
All right, now. Come on.
The New Testament, the book of Luke. And we're going in chapter 23.
All right, now.
Hallelujah. And we're going to be reading. We're going to read verse 32. And then we're going to skip down to 39. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you say it, say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. And let's praise the Lord. So let me read this word for you. Verse 32, Luke chapter 23, verse 32. And it reads, and there were also two other malefactors led with him to be put to death.
Well,
now I'm going to skip down to verse 39, and we're going to go back over this in a little bit. Verse 39 says, and one of the malefactors which were hanging railed on him, saying, if thou be Christ, save thyself and us. But verse 40 says, but the other answered, rebuking him, saying, dost not thou fear God, seeing thou art in the same condemnation? 41, and we indeed justly, for we receive due reward of our deeds, but this man has done nothing amiss. He's done nothing wrong. And verse 42, it said, he said unto Jesus, Lord, now I love this right here. Listen, he said, and Lord, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom. And verse 43, I really love this one because he said, and Jesus said unto him, verily I say unto thee, today, not tomorrow, but today, shall thou be with me in paradise. You may take your seat at this time. Hallelujah. Father God, we thank you for the reading of the word. We thank you, Lord, for your word that you have given to us, Master. We pray that it touch those that are in council right now. Father, for we know that your word shall not return void, but accomplish every intended purpose. It's in Jesus' name we call it done by faith. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I want to talk with you a little bit today. You are familiar with this story. Jesus has been beaten. He has been spat on. He's been ostracized. He's been talked about. And now he's led up onto the hill of Calvary. The place called Golgotha. The place of skulls. Better yet, representation, the place of death. And it says here, and now we know the story of how there was also a man named Simon that had bear the cross for him.
Yes, sir.
And there were some that come up beside him, ladies wailing and crying, and they were offering water and stuff, but he told them, don't worry, daughter. He kept on moving forward, and he got to the place where they hung our Savior. They hung him, crucified him, for something he did not do.
Yes, sir.
But actually, they crucified him for what he did do.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right. Now, listen to this. What I want to focus on is the guy that was hanging with him.
Yes, sir. Come on.
There was two malefactors, one on the right and one on the left. For sake of title today, I want to call this, Know Who You're Hanging With.
All right.
Know who you're hanging with.
Yes, sir.
See, sometimes we get so caught up in where we are, we don't even know who we're hanging with. You got one guy who was there who mocked him.
All right.
And as his action shows, he didn't really believe in the Lord. He mocked him, saying, if you be the Son of God, one writer, John, I think, Mark said, if you be the Son of God, take us down, take us down from here. Us.
Come on now.
But the other one, the other one, which they call the penitent thief. In other words, the good thief. He repented right where he was. I like what he did because he showed it this way that all of us need to take an account right now. They were thieves, is what the Bible said. They were criminals. And he said that this man has done no wrong. We justly deserve what we got, but this man has done nothing. Nothing. But he said, no, we justly deserve what we got. But he asked the spirit, he rebuked him and said, he asked the spirit a good question, said, do you not feel God? See, he acknowledged that he's a believer. You know? See, when he said something about God, he acknowledged he's a believer. It didn't say it because he's a thief that he didn't believe.
Yes,
it didn't say it. He might not have been in church every Sunday, but I'm pretty sure he heard of the healer.
Yes, sir.
I'm pretty sure he heard of the deliverer.
Yes, sir.
I'm pretty sure he heard of the resurrector. But what he does is something very peculiar because he, in the worst of situations, at the place called Skull, the place of death,
yes, sir.
He still inherited the kingdom.
Still.
How many of you going through a situation? I know someone that has gone through a situation that have counted themselves out because they didn't know who they were hanging with. Hallelujah. Listen to me. Some people work on a job, sit right up next to some folks that don't even know who they're sitting next to. See, you have Christ all over you. They don't even speak to you. They come walk by and snarl at you, but they don't even know you. Don't know that you have the answer that can lead them to paradise. Come on, somebody. And see, here it shows me that the malefactor number two that called up on and said, Lord,
yes, sir.
Now when he acknowledged it, he repented.
All right.
He said, Lord, I know I've done wrong.
Yes, all right. All right.
But today, Lord, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom.
Yes, well,
Jesus told him this day. He didn't say tomorrow. He didn't say next week.
All right.
He didn't say next year. He said today.
Today.
Today. You shall be with me in paradise.
Right.
I want somebody to know today that in spite of what you're dealing with right now,
yes,
in spite of a situation that may have you bound, your day is not over.
All right.
Hallelujah. You still have an opportunity to inherit paradise.
Hallelujah.
I know that sometimes it gets hard, the road gets hard. Sometimes it seems like you're traveling alone. But if you know who you're hanging with,
all right.
If you're hanging with the master,
all right.
Paradise is yours.
Yes, sir.
Sometimes we get so quick in the church because of someone's lives and the way that they live. They don't live like us. We count them out.
That's a drive.
Listen to me. We rule people out. You can't rule people out in God's house, in God's kingdom. Because it shows here that at the very end, hanging on the cross, next to the man, the man in the middle, the intercessor, the healer, the deliverer. He
Yes, sir.
When you are in your own despair.
All right.
Don't count yourself out and talk against yourself.
All right.
Don't rule yourself out because it seems like it's the end. Because here it shows me in my Bible that even at the point of death, hallelujah, you can be saved. Hallelujah. Somebody give me praise. See, somebody, that's good news because we allow ourselves to draw back because problems, we sometimes get in hell and hot water and draw back.
All right.
Come on.
But here it showed, as long as you know the Master, as long as you call upon the name of Jesus, as long as you rest in Him, believe on Him. That's what it says, if you believe on Him, you shall be saved. Hallelujah. But I want you to know that there's some things that you have to do. One thing you must accept, one thing you need to acknowledge, you're wrong.
Yes, sir.
Let me show you that. See, that's one thing people don't want to do. They don't want to acknowledge when they're wrong.
Take your time, man.
They don't want to accept the fact that they're not perfect.
All right.
And that they have done wrong in the land. But they want to live any kind of way and receive a blessing.
Quiet, God.
But here shows me that there's a couple of things you have to do. We look over in 2 Chronicles 7 and 14. It says, if my people, which are called by my name.
Yes,
see, there's some steps that he told us to do.
Yes,
hallelujah.
Yeah.
Will humble themselves.
All right.
See, that's another thing of submission. You have to repent.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. Pray. Yes. You got to open yourself in communication and trust in him.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
He said, seek my face.
Yes.
Come on, somebody. Yes. See, you got to seek the Master. Hallelujah.
Yes.
And then he also goes on to say, not until we complete the cycle will you receive the ear from heaven.
Yes,
I want to encourage everyone today. I'm not going to be here long today, but I want to share with you because the land needs you.
Yes.
It needs the Christ in you. It needs that what you have that's greater on the inside to come out or work on the outside. Because if we just standing still, you are not doing what God said to do. Hallelujah.
All right.
You're not acknowledging that he is your Lord if you're not doing what he said to do.
All right.
You must first humble yourself.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Come on.
See, there's a problem.
Thank you, Dad.
There's a problem in the land.
Thank you, Dad.
So many people are prideful. They want to stand up with their chest puffed out. They don't want to submit to nobody's authority. They don't want to sit under anybody's feet. They want to walk around like they got it all together. But I want you to know, my Bible said, if you humble yourself, hallelujah, and then you have to pray. How many people, nobody's praying anymore? Nobody's getting down on their knees only to put their hand in their pocket or tie their shoes. But I said, pray. Hallelujah. And then it also goes on to say one more thing. He wants you to seek his face. When we stop looking at the man next to you, thinking that he got the answer, the preacher got the answer, I have to be in the heart of God. The man of God, the woman of God has to have the heart of God. And if you see God in him, then that is a person that I can show counsel. The Bible says there's safety in the multitude of counsel.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I want you to know that the land is sick now. This neighborhood has so much going on. No one wants to humble themselves. No one wants to seek the Master's face. But I want you to know that even at the end, you don't have to rule yourself out or rule nobody out. Because it shows here that even in the place of stone,
yeah,
now all at the end of time, he's there, he's hanging to be there, to die.
Yes.
He called on the Lord.
Right.
He said, Lord, when you enter into your kingdom, when you enter in that kingdom, Lord, remember me.
Yes.
How many of you are saying that today? Lord, I'm going through everything. I'm dealing with some stuff. I'm dealing with some sickness. I'm dealing with some back hearts, some broken hearted. But Lord, remember me. Hallelujah. And the Lord's answer is today, you shall be saved. Today. How many of you know know that's good news. Hallelujah. I didn't come to spend a whole lot of time today. I want you to know that there's something we have to do more than just standing in one place. Looking to Paul. We know how to dress well on Sunday. We know how to say a good scripture. We know how to make somebody feel good. But see, when it comes down to the nitty-gritty, when we're talking about eternal life, you better know who you're hanging with. Hallelujah. See, some of us, I want to say this to some of the young girls. Don't just jump to get in a relationship with somebody. I'm going to mess with you a little bit. You better do your research and find out who you're messing hanging with. Because see, sometimes you may be hanging with a monster. Someone who does not have your best interest at hand or your heart in their benefit, therefore in their care or belief. They don't care. We move and lose out because sometimes we want to jump into situations without checking the resources. You better check the credentials. I tell you right now, if you ain't walking, talking, praising, worshiping like the Lord, you better run, run, run. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And young men. Come on, there's some of us that won't go with someone because they fine. Look at the big thing, let me tell you something. That's all good and everything. But if they ain't got no Christ in them, if they ain't got the Lord in them, listen to me. You fight the losing battle. Because you're going to get down. How would you understand that if you better know who you're hanging with? Somebody shout glory. Hallelujah. I didn't come to see you a feel good message today. I came to tell the truth. There are people losing and falling by the wayside because they're hanging with any and everybody. There's some people who are challenging everybody without having God in their heart. But I'm here to tell you today, you better get back and make your first love, Jesus. Get back to the Word, the living and the written Word. You better get in the Word. Hallelujah. Because without the Word, we're nothing. The Bible says that here we live, move, and have our being. See, that should be the call of the saint. But if you don't do so, oh, you're fighting to lose a battle. Hallelujah. Keep God in the midst of everything you do. Know that he's riding with you if you're riding with him. Know who you're hanging with. Know who you're hanging with. Churches are failing. Churches are failing because they let any and everybody do everything today. All right. Everything that's not biblical sound. Right. See, they're not hanging with the master. They're hanging with the do-gooders to do what else. And when you do that, the church tears down. The walls fall in. And everybody suffers. Woe to them that scatter the sheep. Scatter the flock. I want you to hear me. We have to know who we're hanging with. When I pick up this Bible, I believe that this word is true. And I can go to the Bible and read on any situation I may encounter in my life. I can't go talk to Pookie now. I can't go talk to Ray right now. But I can get in my closet, get in this word, fall on my knees, and talk to the master. Lord, I need you. It's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer. Hallelujah. Somebody shout glory. My God is able to deliver us from every situation. He is to the name above all names. There's nothing too hard for our God. And if you see here that he got to even to the Mount Calvary, the place called Shur, the place of death, he was saved. So that means if you have time right now, today, you can't wait till tomorrow. Because tomorrow may be too late. Today, if you haven't received Christ as your Lord and Savior, don't wait till tomorrow. Do it today. If you do not claim that he is your, that heaven is your destination, don't wait till tomorrow. Do it today. I love it when he says, this man has done nothing. He's done nothing wrong. Call a spade a spade.
Yes, that's right.
Ah, come on now. Hey, hey, hey.
If it walk like a duck, quack like a duck, it must be a duck. If somebody's wrong with two left shoes, you better call them wrong. Don't try to make them right. Did you hear what I just said? If they left, don't try to make them right. All I'm saying to you is, this man recognized that this man has done no wrong. I've done all. I deserve everything I got. See, because when I look back over my life, saints, listen to me. When I look back over my life, Pastor, I gotta get used to that. Pastor Will, that wasn't always what I looked like. I didn't always live the way I live now. And so when I see people, there are some that get jealous about how we live. I said, what? That's ain't nothing but the devil. All I'm doing is living for the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm not trying to step on their toes. I'm only telling you the truth. Make sure that whatever you do for Christ. You do it with the heart of Christ. Because if you wait too long, you'll miss it. You'll miss it.
Yes.
I want to share, I want to let you know here. Some people hanging around you can either be a blessing or a hindrance. There are some people that are right in your circle that don't mean you good. I'm going to help somebody today. There's somebody that may be in your council. There may be a Judas in the camp. But you have to accept that fact. Judas had an assignment. He had an assignment. But you better recognize who he is and what he's doing. And no, it is not for your benefit. Jesus knew it was important for him to do what he had to do for this sake of going to the cross. They beat him. They spat on him. The Bible says he had 39 lashes. You in the number. These fellas here don't know that they were in the number. One of them did. He took a shot. He said, I tell you what, Lord, I know you didn't do anything.
Come on.
I know that you are innocent of everything that you've done. And I'm guilty. How many of you say that today, there's some things every one of us in here, we're guilty of something. We are guilty of something. We're not squeaky clean. There are times when you need to know that you need to call on the Lord. You need to repent. Repent. If you're wrong, repent. But don't keep going back. The bishop preached last Sunday. Don't go back. You have to push forward. I want to obtain the kingdom of heaven. That is my destination. So I want everyone here today to know, you check the substance of the people you're hanging with. Bread of heaven, I believe this is a good family here. I thank God for this family. I thank God for this house. Because in this house, we come together and we worship together. We praise together. Someone sick, we still pray for one another. Don't just come in and leave out the same way you came in.
Come on, all right.
Hallelujah. Know who you're hanging with. I'm hanging with the Master. I'm hanging with Christ. I'm hanging with a body of believers. Some people just don't want to submit to authority. Oh my God, that's a whole nother sermon. But see, some people don't want to submit or come under some teaching. Sometimes, it ain't always a time for us to jump up and say something. Sometimes we need to sit down and shut up and listen.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
But I thank the Lord that he saw fit to bless me to be here.
Amen.
I thank him for saving me and bringing me out of the gross darkness.
Thank you.
And bringing me into the marvelous light. Because I wasn't always upright and walking and righteous like I am now. But I'm still a work in progress, y'all. Pray for me as I pray for you.
Yes, sir.
I want you to be careful with your lives because time is winding up. I'm going to say that again. Time is winding up. Don't go about your everyday. I'm not telling you. need to live in fear because the Bible said there's no love in fear.
All right.
Ain't no fear in love.
Come on.
You have to live like you're saved. Live like you trust in the Lord. Live like your Lord is the Savior of your life. Be as the man, that the malefactor, the good one, that said, Lord, I know you've done no wrong. He claimed him. He called him Lord. And when he called him Lord, he acknowledged his deity. I want to leave you with this today. I told you I was not going to be long today. I want you to understand this. You are required to do more. I'm going to say it again. There are some things on the inside that is required on the outside. You're required to do more. There are people sitting around you that need a word from you. Someone that need a touch from you. Someone that need the prayers from you. But if we walk and pass somebody, then we're good for nothing.
My God.
So I want to encourage someone today. If this is the hour that you need to acclaim Jesus as your Lord and Savior, let it be. Don't wait till tomorrow. If you have a sickness in your body, come to the altar today.
I thought about today.
I don't want anyone left behind. They say that they missed it.
But
some people miss it because they're looking for something glorious. They're looking for something spectacular to happen when the word is on the inside.
Tomorrow,
I'm going to ask everyone to stand with me. I want everyone to stand all over the building.
Today.
I just want this to be a moment of praise. I want just some people to just throw your hands in the air right now and just close your eyes and just give him praise right where you are. Thank him for all that he's done for you. Thank him for everything that you have gone through and come out of. It's a blessing. He's been with you all the time. I plead the blood of Jesus over this house. I touch and agree with everyone here that anything that we may be going through now, that we shall be healed, delivered, set free. Hallelujah. If there's any that need prayer right now for any reason, we ask that you come to the altar.
Tomorrow,
if there's any right now that need a church home, we ask that you come. Come today. If you just want to stand in the gap for someone else and intercede on someone's behalf, we ask that you come and we'll touch and agree with you. Or we pray right now, bless you. If you are looking to be baptized, come. And if bread of heaven is not your place, we ask that you get in a Bible-based church, but make it a priority to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior.
Upon the
anybody that needs prayer for any situation that you may encounter, there may be anything that you may be going through, we ask that you come now. We pray with you right now. This is the time. Don't be ashamed in God's house. People are waiting on God to do something, but God's waiting on you. He's waiting on you. We got it twisted. We all are waiting for God to do something, but God's waiting on you. Hallelujah. I plead the blood of Jesus all over this building. Over everyone. Under the sound of my voice. Oh, Father, lift the burden to the heart of the broken heart. Something on your job, it may be something just in your everyday living. We ask now that you will come. Let us pray with you. The medicine will join with you and pray with you.
I give my life tomorrow.
Oh, yeah.
I thought about today.
Hallelujah.
But it was much easier to say.
Yes, sir.
Tomorrow.
Everybody, just stay right there. Pray right there where you are.
Tomorrow.
Yeah, you better choose the Lord. Just pray right where you are.
Today. Thank you for tomorrow.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. May very well, may be today.
Come on, give God a hand, praise all over the building. Hallelujah. I thank God for his presence in the building. There are many some that come and others did not, but we pray for you right where you are. We pray blessings over your house and every house attached to this body. We believe in it.